Hello YouTube! Today another video in the God series. Today we're talking about Stendar, the God of Mercy. With today's video I got help again from Mr. Nerddragon from Discord, the same guy that helped me with the video on Kinnereth. If you have not seen that one, or my video on Mara, I suggest you go and watch them, as they're highly interesting just like this one. Alright, then so without further ado, let's kick off with this video. Be kind and generous to the people of Tamriel, protect the weak, heal the sick, and give to the needy. Come to me, Stendar, for without you I might be deaf to the man-swarm mumbling of the people, and forgetting their need to comfort and wisdom. I might indulge myself in vain scribblings. These are the excerpts of Stendar from the Ten Commandments of the Nine Divines and the Pocket Guide to the Empire. And judging by these excerpts, we can see what the god is largely about. Stendar, also known as Stendar the Steadfast, is the god of mercy, charity, well-earned luck, justice, compassion, and righteous rule. According to some early Altmeri legends, he is also the apologist of man. And, in general culture, he is the patron of the Imperial Legion, the patron of the magistrates, rulers, and knights, being their inspiration. Stendar is the comfort of the law-abiding citizen. Also, followers of Stendar and the divines in general when fighting often say, "I offer you the mercy of Stendar, for I shall God not give you any." Or just randomly shout Stendar's mercy, since, you know, he's the god of mercy. We find Stendar's origin largely in the ancient North pantheon. Originally, Stendar was worshipped as Stun, god of Remsen, Shieldthane of Shore. But later he developed into his current form, being part of the Imperial, Bosmer, Breton, Altmer, and Khajiiti pantheons. In Cyrodiil they venerate Stendar as the god of mercy and forbearance. By the 2nd and 3rd eras, a chapel of Stendar was actually located in the city of Coral, and presumably it's still there in the 4th era, but we don't have any confirmation of that, of course. As with the statue of Stendar being in the Aberetium district in the Imperial City, but we also have no confirmation on if that's still the case in the 4th era, but it was there during the 2nd and 3rd era. In the late 3rd era there were also a lot of way shrines of Stendar that could be found all over the province countryside. In elsewhere, the Khajiit worship him as Surendar. You know, surrender, Surendar. Sorry, I find it a very fun pun. But it's actually S apostrophe Rendar. So, Srendar. I really can't pronounce these things. He is Durrant, regarded as the son of Anur and Fadome, who are their forms of Anu and Panome from the conventional pantheons. According to Khajiiti legends, Surendar was actually acclaimed as the god of mercy by their parents, for he was the weakest of their children. So he constantly had to ask for mercy, presumably, so he was also dubbed the god of mercy. By the second era, a shrine of consummate Surendar was located in Jodwood, until its priests were exiled and the shrine fell into ruin, being soon after occupied by bandits. In Morrowind it's a bit of a different story. The majority of Morrowind population does not really venerate Stendar, since most of the Dunmer tend to worship the Reclamation, so Azura, Mephala and Boethia, and before that the Tribute Tribunal, and even before that the Reclamations again. In the late 3rd era, however, a small minority of Dunmer used to worship the Divines, including Stendar. The worship of Stendar, and by extension of the Divines, was more commonly worshipped by the non-Dunmer in Vardenfell and Morrowind, who would pray at the shrines that were operated by the Imperial cult. There used to be a shrine of Stendar and the Divines in the royal palace in Mornhold by that time. After the collapse of the Tribunal Temple, worshippers of the Divines formed the majority of House Lalu, and in the second era there was a shrine of Stendar, although under the form of Stun, so his Nordic form, in Mornhold. In Skyrim there are a bit more conventional ways of worshipping nowadays. In the 4th era Stendar would be a popular god in Skyrim because of his kinda fanatic holy order, the Vigilance of Stendar, which had a strong presence in the province of Skyrim by the 4th era, healing the sick, protecting the weak, and most importantly, hunting down Daedra, werewolves, vampires and other abominations like that do not deserve mercy. However, we will cover the Vigilance of Stendar in another video, as they are more interesting on their own, I think, than as a small line in this video. In High Rock and Hammerfell, Stendarr is venerated by the Red Guard and the Bretons, being the patron of several regions. In the late 3rd era, temples dedicated to Stendarr could be found throughout the Illyak Bay region, during the Elder Scrolls II Daggerfall. They were administrated by the Temple of Stendarr organization. Only healers of the temples of Stendarr would offer their services to both worshippers and heretics, in a true example of the mercy that their god preaches. The Temple of Stendarr was aligned with the Benevolence of Mara, another religion's organization. There was a knightly order dedicated to Stendarr, the Crusaders or Knights of Stendarr. He is considered the most popular divine among Breton and Redguard knights. Now, the Somerset Isles. In the second era, there was a sect dedicated to Stendarr called the Sect of the Harmonious Masters of Lilandriel that abhorred violence, offering healing and knowledge of healing spells to the general populace. But in a very general way, the veneration of Stendarr is frowned upon by many Altmer because of his role as the apologist of man. Presumably, this line of thought either kept going or even increased a bit with the Thalmor dominance over the islands, but this is unknown. Perhaps they even tried to unlink his story from man and made up a whole different story for Stendarr that's more aligned with their elvish supremacy ideology, but honestly, we don't quite know. Now, Stendarr, like the other Aedhra, was born from the mingled blood of Anu and Padomain. After Akathos formed himself and the other gods learned how to do so as well, he was later bound to the Earthbones like the other Divines, having helped with the creation of Mundus. He is said to have accompanied Tiber Septim himself in his later years in the early 3rd era. And the Miracle of Peace, or Warp in the West, is a famous dragon break that occurred in the Illyak Bay in the year 3E417 in the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. This event, the Warp in the West, is often attributed to Stendarr, Mara and Akathos's influence. In his teachings, Stendarr offers mercy to all mortals, welcoming heretics, the afflicted, the hopeless and the forgotten. He cherishes and protected all mortals, whether or not they acknowledge him, and he makes no distinction between worshippers and heretics. The priests of Stendarr also act as a conduit, providing his mercy in his name. Although, who opens their heart to Stendarr gets healed and gains understanding of his love for all mortals, in particular the less fortunate ones. He is very associated with healing, for Stendarr can mend any wound, stay any disease, and soothe any broken soul. It is said that it was Stendarr who bestowed to mortals the gift of magic and the ability to employ it. And mortals can use this to seek Stendarr's wisdom through using restoration magic in his name. Invocating of Stendarr grants the wielder a cloak of blessed light, which can be used offensively as a beam or spear of light, defensively as an armor or shield of sorts, or for healing. However, the mercy of Stendarr does not extend to the enemies of the mortals, often referred to as abominations, which are Daedra, lycanthropies, vampires and the undead, considering them to be abhorrent and unnatural, deserving of no mercy. So what exactly are the values you need as a worshipper of Stendarr? Well, first of all, you should never refuse any aid you are capable of providing. You should go among the infirm and wounded whenever you find them. Of course, you have to offer prayer to Stendarr every day. And you shouldn't hoard wealth or indulge physically. Certainly that first part about wealth stinks, as with the release of Fallout 76, it's pretty clear that Bethesda does not follow Stendarr's teachings at all, and they better start praying to him for mercy for the fans' forgiveness, but that's another point. Well, in terms of artifacts, Stendarr has two known artifacts, them being the Gauntlets of the Crusader, particularly part of the Crusader's relics which we can find in Oblivion, which boost the restoration skills of the user and grants resistance to disease. And we have Stendarr's hammer, a massive hammer that is said to have been used by the god himself, being capable of damaging or draining the health of whoever strikes it at the cost of the wielder's stamina. It is so heavy that 4 men were needed to simply raise it to display it at a podium on Thorasa Aram's museum in Mournhold in the Elder Scrolls Morrowind. So, on a little side note, the hammer of Stendarr was apparently seen in Skyrim in the 4th era, during the time of the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. It was apparently in possession of Calselmo of Markarth, having put the hammer in his museum, but the artifact was stolen soon after. But the problem is that this is Creation Club content, and we have to indulge into a discussion if that's canon first. We had a vote on this channel, so democracy in, well, practice, that if there's any Creation Club content on a matter, I would mention it, but I would leave the matter if it's canon or not in the middle, since some people say that it's canon, and apparently a guy from the Creation Club curating that who actually works at Bethesda said it is canon, although I could not have find it anywhere online, but I'll leave it in the middle. Just know that there's Creation Club content that places the Stendarr's hammer in Skyrim. Other than that, that's all that I can say about the Hammer of Stendarr and Stendarr himself. Once again, a huge thanks to Mr. Nerddragon from Discord. If you see him on any of the Elder Scrolls Discords, just, I don't know, give him a friendly emoji or something. And with that said, I will see you all in the next video. If you like this video, click like, subscribe, do all those things. I'm too sick to do the entire thing. Patreon also there. And damn, I need to go back to bed. You can maybe hear it in my voice. I will see you all in the next video.